Embark on a 3D adventure that captures the spellbinding process of a butterfly's metamorphosis. From the humble beginnings in an egg, through the voracious caterpillar phase, to the majestic rise of the butterfly. Witness each transformational stage as we capture the intricate processes that define one of nature's most graceful spectacles. With the awakening of spring, the swallowtail's butterflies meet on the tops of the hills, where they find their mates in a summit courtship display. After mating, the female begins to search for a suitable place and lays her eggs individually on wild carrot, dill, parsley, fennel, and other plants selected for specific nutrients. The egg of the swallowtail undergoes a remarkable transformation. At first, it is milky white, but soon it develops a reddish-brown grain and finally turns black-purple in color. Shortly before the caterpillar hatches, the black head can already be seen through the eggshell. After 6 to 10 days, the caterpillar breaks through the eggshell. Its first meal? Its own eggshell, a source of nutrients that gives it a start in life. The swallowtail caterpillar then goes through several molts, a process that enables it to grow and develop. Initially, the caterpillar is grey-black with a white saddle patch, perfectly camouflaged as bird droppings to fool predators. With each molt, its appearance changes dramatically. It develops orange spots and becomes lighter in colour. These colour changes not only serve as camouflage, but also signal their toxicity to potential predators. The caterpillar eats its old skin after each molt, an act that emphasises nature's efficiency. From the third molt onwards, the caterpillar's base colour takes on a greenish tone, and over time, it reaches its characteristic green-orange colouring. The newly hatched caterpillar starts with a length of 3 millimetres and a weight of just 0.00047 grams. By the time they are fully mature, the length increases to 90 millimetres and the weight to 3.65 grams, which corresponds to a 30-fold increase in length and a 7 to 8,000-fold increase in weight. To illustrate this impressive growth performance, a 3 kilograms newborn reaching the weight of 4 adult elephants within 2 months would undergo a similar development. When the caterpillar has finally reached its full size, it looks for a suitable place to pupate. It anchors itself to a dry plant stem and encloses itself in a chrysalis, which can be either green or brown-grey, depending on the environment, to provide the best possible camouflage. At this stage, it completes its breathtaking transformation into a swallowtail, ready to continue the cycle of life. The butterfly's fascinating metamorphosis is controlled by two hormones, ecdysone and juvenile hormone. Ecdysone, the molting hormone, which is released by the prothoracic gland, initiates the transition from caterpillar to chrysalis and then to butterfly. The juvenile hormone, on the other hand, produced by the corpora alata, ensures that the caterpillar does not become a butterfly directly after each molt, but only after several stages of development. When the time is ripe and the production of the juvenile hormone decreases, ecdysone takes over and completes the metamorphosis into a butterfly. In the hidden chamber of the chrysalis, one of nature's greatest miracles takes place: the transformation of the caterpillar into a butterfly. This process, also known as complete metamorphosis or holometabolism, transforms a simple foraging caterpillar into a magnificent flying creature, adorned with vibrant iridescent wings. During the metamorphosis of caterpillars into butterflies, the cells release enzymes known as caspases, which break down cell proteins. Contrary to the assumption that the caterpillar dissolves into a formless soup, some organs are actually left intact during this process and transform, while much of the tissue is broken down into its basic proteins. For example, the tracheal system of the butterfly remains largely unchanged, except for increasing complexity in the thoracic region. At the same time, the gut transforms from an elongated larval structure into a shorter, complexly shaped adult gut, supported by the development and new formation of further internal structures, such as malpighian tubules. Organs that are superfluous for the later butterfly are completely decomposed, such as the silk glands. Other organs, such as muscles, break down into reusable clusters of cells, similar to a Lego sculpture disassembled into individual parts, and are transformed and reconfigured for butterfly life. Some muscles serve only the caterpillar and are completely broken down, while others are completely recreated for the butterfly's life, such as those needed for the butterfly's wing movement. Particularly remarkable is the growth of the brain, which undergoes considerable development in the butterfly, supported by so-called stem or imaginal cells. Certain cells withstand the internal decay caused by enzymes and become foundational for external structures. These essential cells are part of what's known as imaginal discs, special cellular structures formed in the larvae of holometabolous insects, those experiencing complete metamorphosis. These discs are crucial for shaping the various body parts of the adult insect, such as wings, legs, and antennae, and are meticulously organized within the larva to ensure precise development of these parts. When they activate, they begin to unfold, differentiate, and finally form the adult structures for which they are intended. In the process, they turn inside out and expand, with the central areas of the discs forming the more distant parts of the respective appendage, such as the leg. Remarkable is the fusion of the eye antennal discs, from which the elegant antennae and the multi-layered compound eyes of the butterflies are formed. After breaking through the chrysalis, the butterfly initially presents itself in a fragile state, its wings still moist and folded. It takes a few hours for them to dry and unfold before the butterfly is ready to take to the skies. The lifespan of adult butterflies is usually short, a fleeting moment of beauty in their life cycle. The metamorphosis of butterflies is a captivating chapter in the book of nature, a story of change and reawakening. With each transition, from the protective chrysalis to free flight, they reveal the splendor of change and the fragility of life. These fleeting creatures, whose existence is a kaleidoscope of colors and shapes, teach us to appreciate the beauty of the now and to accept impermanence as part of the eternal cycle of nature.